40 degree chest machine. And you can substitute a fly machine if you like, but this is the one we have here at High Intensity Headquarters. And go ahead and start, bring it again up 4 seconds. Now this one you will hold at the top. This is not a rest position, so squeeze 2 seconds and then release it slow. Any exercise where you're at a peak contracted position or where it's work, you want to hold it for 2 seconds. And again, make sure with a partner that you're going really slow. Have somebody there watching you to make sure you're doing it right. And again, this is after a proper warm-up. So 1, 2, 3, 4. If it's your second exercise, you can go right to your workout weight. If it's your first one, though, you want to warm up like with the flat chest press, which we did first. 1, 2, good. See, 3. Again, eliminating momentum, making the muscles do all the work. We want to fully exhaust them in one set. The goal with the chest fly is to just isolate the pectoral muscle and then exhaust it. And then we're going to go over to a dip press and bring other muscles into play, like triceps, front deltoid, to push the chest even further. So he's using really good form. He's focused. And then again, make sure he squeezes all the way together. Hold. Quick 2 seconds, real slow. I like the 40 degree chest because it's a little easier angle on the shoulder. And it also gets the upper pecs. He's close to failure here. You can take it to the point where you cannot move it anymore. Most of the time, you just want in your workouts to just go to failure. Don't add anything like forced reps or negatives or drop sets. Only do that sparingly, maybe every fourth workout. Good. Come on, man. Don't help him, but just your hands there makes people just close it up. Come on. Breathe. Give me everything you got. Everything. Come on. Come on. That's all you. Good job. That was failure. He could not close it. Excellent. Slow down. Way down there. Good. That was a good set. All right.